you can, because like, if they come into play and they can possess people, like, that's a cool aspect of it. But I was even thinking, now that we're going to take that, let's take that a step further, because I was just thinking maybe people could do like the full Jedi training, because they'll have access to all the information needed for a full Jedi training, however many years that would take, because if they did kidnap Hu Yang, he's got all the information stored. So you have someone who kidnaps this droid, or at least like kidnaps it for a small amount of time, but is able to really copy every piece of data from him, and then he gets released and no one really knows that they stole that data. Like, that could be another aspect of it too, because now Hu Yang's back, so it's not, you know, maybe they rescue him, but they're a little bit too late to stop the information from being copied. Now they got all this information, you have someone really take the time and build out an army of people who are somewhat skilled and have maybe force-sensitive properties, but now you've got a full Jedi training, and you train them from the very beginning exactly how it was supposed to be in the Jedi Order, but now they're the flip side of Jedi, the bad Jedi. That's even worse than the possessed Jedi, because they're actually going to be skilled and they're actually going to know things. And so you add that to it, I just think you got a really big fight on your hands. And honestly, you probably have to bring in our old pal Luke Skywalker to start handling some shit, because like that's what you have to do. Because right now, Luke Skywalker in this timeline is still in his prime, right? Like, we just saw him when he showed up and picked up Grogu a couple years ago. So he's not an old man by any means. He's in his prime of being Luke Skywalker. This is the time. Like, this is 100% the time where you do something crazy like that, and you need to have the legendary Jedi come in and try to save your ass. And even then, who's to say that it's even possible? You have a full-blown army of anti-Jedi who are trained in the Jedi ways, but for the bad. You got one hell of an army on your hands, and one hell of an enemy to deal with.
Yeah, man, and that's a question too. Like, what the hell is Luke doing right now?
So I don't know. It depends. If he's been training things before Grogu, then yeah, it probably is the direct timeline. But if Grogu was the first one, it's probably going to build up to him training Ben Solo. So it just depends on that. We don't really know Luke's training schedule, who was his first pupil, who was his first whatever. And if we learn that, we'll be able to kind of place in the timeline of when Luke started training Ben Solo.
Technically, you got Han still kicking it, man. Let's get our boy back. Let's get that AI working, you know what I mean? Got him. Yeah, imagine that, right? And this is way out of left field, but just for fun. Like, imagine if you had Han Solo come back to, like, help lead the Mandalorians with Din Djarin. And then you had Luke come back to help lead whatever Jedis are left. And then, like, at the very end of, like, the Mandalorian, like, you have these armies that you came up with. And the last clip is Luke and Han that just, like, showed up. That'd be fucking, I don't know.
I honestly think that's the only way that you win that battle, is if you have all those guys. You telling me I'm gonna be able to see a semi-prime Han Solo, Chewbacca, Luke, and I don't know if they'd end up recasting or whatever for Leia, but you can tell me I'm gonna see all those people as we saw them in the 70s, and they're gonna be part of the whole deal of taking down this new potential enemy that we just created out of our minds here because we're going crazy on the show today. You know what I mean? Like, saying, let's capture Hu Yang. Let's get the Jedi information over to the bad guys. Yeah, you know? But, like, you know, somebody, you're telling me, you got me sold. Like, take my money. Like, take my money if I get to watch all these guys. Like, you know, I want to kind of see it happen to where they try to do it just themselves. Maybe the Mandalorian and Ahsoka get together and they try and they're starting to get real fucked up, and I know you just see them pull up and it's fucking time to roll, baby. Let's do it. Like, I'm in. Like, I'm pumped right now. I got goosebumps. I'm ready to watch that shit, dude.
Like, imagine just like this very end here. Like, they're about to get fucked, and then you have Luke Millennium fucking Falcon fly in, just starts mowing people fucking down, getting off the ramp is Luke, Han, and Chewy. Everyone would fucking lose their fucking mind. Like, how fucking cool would that be?
Yeah, it'd be awesome. It'd be very similar to that Avengers Endgame when the portals open and you see all those badass motherfuckers flying through ready to take out Thanos. It'd be the Star Wars equivalent of that. You know, you see all these people go down, the armorer goes down, and Din Djarin's taking a lot of fire, Grogu's kind of, you know, not doing the hottest, Ahsoka's, like, one of her lightsabers is broken, you see Sabine Wren laying on the ground, like, you see all these things happen, and all of a sudden, you just said the Millennium Falcon pulls up, and you're just like, oh shit, now the real battle starts, let's go, like, yeah, I'm in, take my money.
Dude, you heard it on Chase and Josh Factor Fantasy First, which... You know, just saying that's happened a couple times on this show.